Aid is on the way for Filipinos under strict lockdown in Shanghai. The Overseas Workers Welfare Administration says they can begin providing food assistance to them this Thursday or Friday. The agency is also looking at handing out cash aid.
Meron na tayong at least, at the very least, mga 500 na mga pangalan na ipinresenta sa atin. So handa na tayong tumulong. Yung ating initial set of assistance ay handa na nating i-roll out. Unahin muna natin ang food assistance, pero inahanay na rin natin ang possible cash assistance. Wala kaming nakikitang hadlang na in terms of yung pagsasagawa ng food distribution. And again, may mga paraan po tayo na hindi kailangang kinakailangan magkaroon ng actual na pag-aabot ng food drive. Posibleng grocery voucher system na padadala sa kanila through electronic.
Philippine Ambassador to China, Chito Santa Romana, passes away. His family said Santa Romana died in Wangsha in China's Anhui province on April 18th. His cause of death was not revealed. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department honored Santa Romana, saying, under his tenure, ties between Manila and Beijing flourished despite differences. It adds he will be remembered for his legacy of selfless service to Filipinos in the most challenging foreign post. China's ambassador to the Philippines also paid tribute to Santa Romana, saying he greatly values their time working together. He also thanks Santa Romana for the friendship and his undeniable contribution to the development of China-Philippines relations. Malacañang also mourning the death of Santa Romana.
Nagdadalamhati po kami sa pagyao ni Philippine Ambassador to China, His Excellency Jose Santiago Chito Santa Romana. Nagbibigay pugay kami sa Ambassador o kay Ambassador Santa Romana sa kanyang mga nagawa para tumibay ang Philippine-China relations. Our thoughts and prayers to the Santa Romana family.
Santa Romana was an award-winning journalist before serving as the country's ambassador to China. A Florida judge has overturned the U.S. government's mask mandate in public transport. The judge called it unlawful, saying U.S. officials exceeded their authority. The lawsuit was filed last year by a group challenging state and federal vaccine and mask mandates across the country. The decision comes just days after the Biden administration extended by 15 days the mandate requiring individuals to wear masks on planes, trains, and other public transport.
So this is obviously a disappointing decision. The CDC continues recommending wearing a mask in public transit. As you know, this just came out this afternoon. So right now, the Department of Homeland Security, who would be implementing, and the CDC are reviewing the decision. And of course, the Department of Justice would make any determinations about litigation.
Shanghai reports 7 new COVID-19 deaths Tuesday, bringing the official toll from the current outbreak to 10. Those who died were reportedly aged between 60 and 101 and had severe underlying health conditions. Shanghai also reported 20,416 new cases, a decline from a recent peak but still elevated. China's financial hub has been on lockdown for 3 weeks to control an Omicron-fueled outbreak. China is sticking to its COVID zero strategy despite concerns about the policy's growing social and economic toll.